2015 has been quite the year for Mars.
Today we're going to announce that under certain circumstances, liquid water has been found on Mars.
NASA also discovered Mars's once-thick atmosphere was likely stripped away by the sun, and it continues to be a source of intrigue. The European Space Agency's 2018 ExoMars mission will search for life on the Martian surface, while billionaire Elon Musk hopes to eventually establish a Mars colony.
I want to enable large numbers of people and cargo to go to Mars.
Now, the United Arab Emirates has also set its sights on the Red Planet. It hopes to land a probe on Mars by 2021. The probe is called HOPE, and for a good reason. Traveling over 100 million miles from Earth to Mars is not easy.
Mars is difficult. There's a lot of difficulties with this mission, and the team realizes that when it comes to actually building the spacecraft, launching it, operating it, because reaching Mars is just halfway through the journey. You still have to get the data, analyze it, and come up with good science.
A team of young Emirati scientists in collaboration with experts from the US have taken on the ambitious task to develop, build, and launch HOPE by 2020.
It is the first mission to Mars that will look at the atmosphere in a holistic manner. It will understand the atmospheric dynamics and also the weather dynamics that occur over a full Martian year. We're focusing on the loss of hydrogen and oxygen and escape into space.
The Mohammed bin Rashid Space Center was established in Dubai in 2005 with a team of 5 people. 10 years on, and the team has grown to 80, with 2 Earth-observing satellites in space and another due to launch in 2018. HOPE is the center's first mission not focusing on Earth.
So engineers are now going to start their initial design work of how the probe is going to look like, how it's going to be developed, and how we're going to get the actual physical structure in place.
Despite critics questioning the 6-year timeline, the team says it's on schedule, as Mr. Sharaf keeps track of developments with a paper timeline taped across his office.
Since the establishment of the center, they've always been like, those are kids, they don't know what they're doing. Even this mission, people ask me, were telling me, is this one of your like stunts or public propaganda sort of moves that you guys usually do? I'm like, nope, it's not. If we wanted to do this mission for other purposes, for the media purposes, we would have just went and bought the system, okay, and launched it and made the biggest sort of PR work around it. But that's not what we did.
And the team have another goal.
Okay, we have the technical side of the mission, but there's also the other soft side of the mission, which is preparing a generation, the next generation of UAE scientists, and also inspiring the whole region to start innovating and giving back to humanity.